Hi friends, let's study C15 of ISBP 745. C15 is very important article, particularly B part of that. So let's start. C15A. When a drawing or shipment by installments within a period is stipulated in the credit and any installment is not drawn or shipped within the period allowed for that installment, the credit ceases to be available for that and any subsequent installment. Let's take an example, because that is article 32, same as that the sentences. LCC is 500 kg in April, 700 kg in May, 800 kg in June and 300 kg in July. Now if any one of these shipments is not done, means if 700 kg is not done, then the LC will cease to exist for this 700 kg and also for the subsequent ones, means June and July also. Then the LC does not exist for May, June and July if any May installment is not done. This you can also see in the article 32 video of mine. So we need not waste our time on this first sentence. Important part is further. Now this sentence is important. Given periods are the sequence of dates or timelines that determine start and end date for each installment. Remember, start date and end date should be there for installment shipments. For example, a credit requiring shipment of 100 cars in March and 100 in April is an example of two periods of time that start on 1st March and 1st April and end on 31st March and 30th April respectively. See, this black example is similar one. 500 kg in April means we know when April starts and when it ends. 700 kg in May means we know when it starts and when it ends. So start date and end date should be there. Second, when partial drawings or shipments are allowed, any number of drawings or shipments is permitted within each installment. Remember this. It means in this case, if partial shipments are allowed, then what will happen is this guy, this Benny, can send 100 kg on 5th April, 100 kg on 10th April, means totally can make 500 kgs. In April, he can send it any number of installments. Similarly for May, June and July. I can even send 1 kg each for 30 days, means 3 to 4, 10 kgs in each day and make it 500 kgs. What I meant is, I can even send 50 kg each day and make it 500 kgs in April, similarly in May. Now B, when a credit indicates a drawing or shipment schedule by only indicating the number of latest dates, remember this word, and not given periods as given in A1, means start date and end date, if that is not there, then number 1, this is not an installment schedule as envisaged by UCP 600 and article 32 will not apply. Remember this part, means article 32 will not apply, but the presentation is to otherwise comply with any instructions in respect of the drawing or shipment schedule and UCP 600 article 31, means partial drawings or shipments is will apply, but installment will not apply. This red case, 500 kg by April end, by May end, by June end and by July end. It means only if last dates are given, then article 32 does not apply. Let's look at the logic. If issuance date is February 1 and April end 500 kg, May end 700 kg, it means May end 700 kg means I can ship from February 1 to May end. I can ship from February 1 to June end. February 1 to July end, there is no start date. That's why this installment shipment is not applicable in this case. It means myself as a beneficiary can send the whole 700 kg on February 10th only. Similarly, whole 800 kg on February 10th only. Remaining 300 also on February 10th only. Means in the month of February only I can send all these shipments, because it is given by end of this, not after this end, but before that I can ship any time. That's why installment shipments is not applicable over here. That's it on C15. You can download YogaGuru app from Play Store to get these videos, online tests, question banks with explanations directly on your mobile. You can get the physical